Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Pradnya Kedari. In the last module, we have covered primary active transport. Now in this module, we will be covering next subtopic of active transport, that is secondary active transport. So this module covers topics like introduction of active transport, secondary active transport, their types, mechanisms and few examples. Cell also need to move molecules against concentration gradient. Active transport is a transport of molecule which requires expenditure of energy to move solute against concentration gradient using ATP. Active transport mechanisms uses cell's energy usually in the form of ATP, that is adenosine triphosphate. In case of secondary active transport, ATP is utilized indirectly. It is also called as uphill transport, moving against a gradient. Small substances are constantly passing through plasma membrane. It keeps on fluctuating the electrochemical gradient of a cell. Therefore, for a cell, it needs to spend an energy to move substances against concentration gradient or electrochemical gradient. This energy is gained from hydrolysis of ATP, which is generated through the cell's metabolism. Active transport maintains the concentration of ions and other substances using ATP as energy source. There exist two mechanisms for the transport of small molecular weight material and small molecules. First is primary transport, which we have already seen in earlier module, and second is secondary active transport, which describes the movement of material that is due to the electrochemical gradient established by primary active transport that does not directly require any energy. In this module, we will be studying the modes of secondary active transport. Mechanism. Primary active transport of Na plus is responsible for formation of electrochemical gradient. This gradient becomes energy as the excess sodium is constantly trying to diffuse to the interior of a cell. Secondary active transport is also a form of active transport across the biological membrane. In this type, a transporter protein couples the movement of an ion, which mostly is Na plus or H plus, down its electrochemical gradient to another molecule or ion against the concentration gradient. That is, downhill process is coupled with the uphill process to assist its movement. In this way, energy stored in the electrochemical gradient of an ion is used to move another solute against concentration or electrochemical gradient. Movement of this ion moving down its electrochemical gradient drives the uphill movement of another molecule, and therefore it is referred as driving ions. In secondary active transport, coupling between the driving and driven species is obligatory, and therefore it is commonly referred as ion coupled transport. It means both the driving and driven species must be bound to transporter for translocation across the membrane to occur. In primary transport, ATP hydrolysis provides a free energy needed to move the solute against the concentration gradients. But in the secondary active transport, the free energy needed to perform active transport is provided by concentration gradient of driving ion. An existence and maintenance of concentration gradient of the driving ion is accomplished by primary active transporters, that is pumps. Thus, it is appropriate to call this process as secondary active transport. There are variations of secondary active transport. First is co-transport, which is also known as symport, and second is exchange, which is also known as antiport. The transport of proteins responsible for secondary active transports are referred to as secondary active transport. The proteins responsible for co-transport are specially referred to as co-transporters or also known as symporters, and the proteins responsible for exchange are specifically referred as exchangers. Sodium is the driving ion for many cotransporters as well as many exchangers. Therefore, these transport proteins may also be referred to as sodium-coupled cotransporters. Similarly, there are many examples of proton-coupled cotransporters and exchangers too. Secondary active transport, the movement of driving ion down an electrochemical gradient is used to drive the uphill transport of another molecule against the concentration gradient. In cotransport, the direction of transport is same for both the driving ions and driven molecules, whereas in exchange, the driving ion and driven ion are transported in the opposite direction. In the figure, if X and Y represent transporters, substrates, P is inorganic phosphate. Symport. Symport or cotransport means that the molecule is allowed to be transported from high to low concentration region while moving another molecule with it from low to high concentration. It in fact is like pulling the other molecule with driving molecule or ion into the cell. Example is sodium glucose cotransporter. The mechanism is, in this case, on its exterior side, the transporter protein has two binding sites. One is for sodium and other one is for glucose. When both of these bind to protein, there is a conformational change which allows the transport. Electrochemical gradient provides the energy needed to transport both of these molecules into the cell. Next example is sodium amino acid cotransporter. Mechanism is same as above except that it uses different set of transporter proteins. Symport or cotransport are present especially through the epithelial cells of the intestinal tract and the renal tubules of kidney to enable absorption of these substances into the blood. Another cotransport, for example, is Na plus glucose cotransporter, which is also known as SGLT1. In this, the direction of transport is same for both the driving ion and driven molecule. Na plus and glucose cotransporters are found in the small intestine and kidney proximal tubules. It simultaneously transports two Na plus ions and one glucose molecule into the cell across the plasma membrane. In contrast, the driving ion and driven molecule move in opposite direction. For example, Na plus Ca2 plus exchanger. It is found in the cardiac muscle cells and elsewhere in the body. It transports 3 Na plus ions into the cell in exchange for 1 Ca2 plus ion transported out of the cell. All the cotransporters do not utilize Na plus as driving ion. Some uses existing proton electrochemical gradient too. Example is H plus oligopeptide transporter, which is found in the small intestine. It couples the downhill movement of H plus across the plasma membrane to uphill transport of dipeptides and tripeptides into the cell against the concentration gradient. All the secondary active transporters are not necessarily found on the plasma membrane. They are also present on the membrane of internal organelles. For example, H plus neurotransmitter exchangers. It is found in the membrane of synaptic vesicle in axon terminals. It utilizes H plus electrochemical gradient, that is proton electromotive force established by the V type of H plus ATPase gradient, and it facilitates the uphill transport of neurotransmitter into the lumen of synaptic vesicle. In all the cases, the electrochemical gradient of driving ion is maintained by primary active transporters. The Na plus gradient across the plasma membrane is maintained by Na plus K plus ATPase, and the proton gradient across the synaptic vesicle membrane is maintained by H plus ATPase. Transport coupling stoichiometry determines the effectiveness of substrate transport against the concentration gradient. For both cotransporters and exchangers, the effectiveness of transport process can be defined by concentrative capacity of a transport process. Concentrative capacity is a measure of how well the driven ion or molecule is concentrated against the concentration gradient. For example, for Na plus glucose cotransporter, concentrative capacity can be expressed as the ratio of intracellular to extracellular glucose concentration. This ratio indicates how well the Na plus glucose cotransporters can move glucose inside of the cell against the concentration gradient. For any given transporter, the coupling stoichiometry is usually a fixed ratio. A higher ion or substrate coupling ratio leads to significantly higher concentrative capacity of transport. Cotransporters and exchangers may be electrogenic or electroneutral. A transporter that leads to net translocation of charges across the membrane is said to be electrogenic. For example, with a coupling stoichiometry of 2 Na plus ions to 1 glucose molecule, Na plus glucose cotransporter by SGLT represents an electrogenic process. Such charge movement across the membrane leads to small electrical current, and therefore electrophysical method may be used to measure the activity of electrogenic transporters. A consequence of the ion or substrate coupling ratio is that the activity of some cotransporters and exchanger lead to translocation of net charges across the membrane. When no net charges is transported across the membrane per transport cycle, the process is said to be electroneutral. Direction of transport is determined by electrochemical or concentration gradient of the driving ion or species. Cotransport protein, that is cotransporters or symporters. These are found in many different cells and tissues and perform variety of important physiological functions. Examples of cotransporters. The Na plus glucose cotransporter is found in the apical membrane of epithelial cell of a small intestine and renal proximal tubules. It utilizes the Na plus electrochemical gradient to drive the uphill transport of the glucose into the cell. As mentioned above, the ion substrate coupling stoichiometry of SGLT is 2 Na plus ions as to 1 glucose molecule. Therefore, SGLT1 is electrogenic transporter. In addition to glucose, SGLT1 recognizes galactose as a substrate. Its function is crucial to dietary glucose and galactose absorption in small intestine and reabsorption of the filtered glucose and galactose in the proximal tubule of kidney nephrons. Next example is Na plus phosphate cotransporters, that is NAPI. It is found in the apical membrane of epithelial cells of small intestine and renal proximal tubules. It utilizes the Na plus electrochemical gradient to drive the uphill transport of inorganic phosphate into the cell. For every transport cycle, NAPI type 1 as well as type 2 couples the inward translocation of 3 Na plus ions as to 1 divalent PI. Thus, NAPI types 2A and 2B are electrogenic transporters. The third type, that is NAPI 2C, which is not shown here, is electroneutral with a coupling stoichiometry of 2 Na plus to 1 divalent PI, the Na plus I minus symporters. It is responsible for accumulation of iodide by the thyroid gland. It is localized to basolateral membrane of thyroid follicular cells and co-translocates 2 Na ions and 1 iodine ion per transport. These NIS is also found in other tissues such as mammary glands, where it functions to transport iodide into nursing mother's milk. Na plus Cl minus co-transporters, that is NCC. It utilizes the Na plus electrochemical gradient to drive Cl minus transport into the cell with 1 Na plus as to 1 Cl minus coupling stoichiometry. NCC is found in the apical membrane of epithelial cells of kidney nephron distal tubules. Next is K plus Cl minus cotransporters, that is KCC. These cotranslocates 1 K plus and 1 Cl minus out of the cell per cycle. Here, driving ion is K plus. Activity of the Na plus K plus ATPase creates a large outwardly directed K plus electrochemical gradient. NCC and KCC are all electroneutral co-transporters. The transporter for inhibitory neurotransmitter aminobutyl acid, that is GABA, belonging to large family of Na plus and Cl minus coupled transporters. The GABA transporters, that is GAT, regulates the basal concentration of GABA in the nervous system. It regulates the concentration and lifetime of GABA in the synaptic cleft. The GABA translocators coupled with the inward translocation of both of 2 Na plus and 1 Cl minus as to 1 GABA. Therefore, GABA transporters are electrogenic. Other transporters belonging to this family are transporters for neurotransmitters, that is serotonin and dopamine. Also, transporters for the osmolytes betaine and taurine. Antiport exchangers are also called as counter transport, which means that two different molecules or ions are transported at the same time in opposite direction. One of the species is allowed to flow from high concentration to lower concentration, which is often sodium, while the other species is transported simultaneously to the other side. Examples of exchangers. Exchangers are also known as antiporters. They are found in many different cells and tissues. They perform variety of important physiological functions. Three examples are shown here. They are as follows: Na plus Ca2 plus exchanger, that is NCX, which is ubiquitously found in many cells and tissues. It plays an important role in cytoplasmic Ca2 plus homeostasis. It couples the inward movement of 3 Na ions down the Na plus electrochemical gradient to the uphill movement of 1 Ca2 plus ion against the electrochemical gradient. Resting Ca2 plus concentration values in the cytoplasm is 70 nm and extracellular fluid is 2 mm respectively. Therefore, NCX is electrogenic. Na plus H plus exchanger. It is ubiquitously found exchanger and it plays important role in regulation of cytoplasmic pH. Here again, the Na plus electrochemical gradient is utilized by exchanger to extrude H plus from the cell with 1 Na plus as to 1 H plus coupling stoichiometry. Thus, NHE is electroneutral. Cl bicarbonate exchanger. It is widely distributed and also referred as ion exchanger or AE. The coupling stoichiometry of transport is 1 Cl minus to 1 HCO3 minus and therefore, the exchanger is electroneutral. These exchangers belong to the same family as Na plus coupled bicarbonate co-transporters. The direction of transport by Cl minus bicarbonate exchanger is decided by the concentration gradient of Cl minus and bicarbonates. For example, in RBCs, that is erythrocytes which are traveling in the systematic capillaries, CO2 hydration reactions catalyzed by carbonic anhydrase result in excess production of bicarbonate in the cytoplasm. This concentration drives the outward translocation of HCO3- in exchange for inward translocation of Cl-. When the red cell passes through the lung capillaries, the direction of transport is reversed. It is reversed in such a way that inward translocation of bicarbonate is coupled to outward translocation of Cl-. Bicarbonate that enters the cell ultimately gives rise to CO2, which catalyzed by bicarbonic anhydrase. This CO2 then leaves the cell and ultimately the capillaries and enter the air filled with alveoli of the lung, where it is then exhaled into the atmosphere. In this way, we have learned regarding mechanism and type of secondary active transport where energy is utilized indirectly. Such secondary active transport is used to store high energy hydrogen ions in the mitochondria of plant as well as animal cells. The potential energy in the hydrogen ion is translated into kinetic energy and that energy is used to convert ADP into ATP. Thank you.